In this session, we are going to see some other classification methods like genetic algorithms, fuzzy set approach, and rough set approach. So first we'll see about what is the classification methods based on genetic algorithms. So as you know, genetic algorithms attempt to incorporate ideas of natural evolution. So in general, genetic learning starts as follows. So how we are doing genetic algorithm methods. So first, an initial population is created consisting of randomly generated rules. So each rule can be represented by a string of bits. For example, suppose that a sample in a given training set are described by two Boolean attributes A1 and A2, and that there are two classes C1 and C2. The rule like if A1 and not A2, then C2 can be encoded as the bit string 100. So what we are doing first in the genetic algorithm is, first we have an initial population, and with that initial population we are generating the rules, but each rule we are representing with string of bits. So as I told, suppose we are having two attributes A1 and A2, and we are having C1 and C2, and we are having one rule like if A1 and not A2. That means A1 attribute is there, A2 attribute is not there. Then it is belonging to C2 class. Such cases we can represent it with a bit string like 100. That means 1 means A1 is present, 0 means A2 is not present, and again 0 means it's belonging to 0 class, right? Suppose another rule like if A1 and A2, that means both A1 and A2, then it will become 1 1, and it belonging to C1 means C1 is represented by 1, then it will become 1 1 1 like that. So like this, each rule will be represented with a set of bits. So similarly, another example is if not A1 and not A2, then it is belonging to C1 class. So how it will be? If not A1 means it will be 0, and not A2 means again it will be 0, and then it is belonging to C1 class. C1 class we are representing with 1, then it will become the rule is represented by 0, 0, 1. If an attribute has k values, that means where k is greater than 2, then k bits may be used to encode the attributes values. Here it is only two attributes, whatever the examples we told. So it will be represented only with 2. If there are k bits, then it will be represented with k number of bits if there are k attributes. Now, even classes also can be encoded in a similar fashion. So based on the notion of survival of the fittest, a new population is formed to consist of the fittest rules in the current population as well as the offspring of these rules. Typically, the fitness of a rule is assessed by its classification accuracy on a set of training samples. Similarly, offsprings are created by applying genetic operations such as crossover and mutation. So new rules will be, we are going to create a new rule using crossover and mutation concept in genetic algorithm. So in crossover, substrings from pairs of rules are swapped to form new pair of rules. So how we are doing in the case of crossover, the substrings from pairs of rules are swapped in to form new pairs of rules. In mutation, randomly selected bits in a rule string are inverted. So the process of generating new populations based on prior populations of rules continues until a population P evolves where each rule P satisfies a pre-specified fitness threshold. So the process of generating new populations based on prior populations of rules continues until a population P evolves where each rule in P satisfies a pre-specified fitness threshold. So genetic algorithms are easily parallelizable and have been used for classification as well as other optimization problems. In data mining, they may be used to evaluate the fitness of other algorithms. So we are not going so deeply to genetic algorithms. So what actually genetic algorithms is, with the initial population, we will generate a set of rules, right? And each rule will be represented with a bit of string, group of bits, right? And whenever a new things, if we wanted to do, we'll use the genetic algorithm concept like crossover and mutation to implement new set of rules. So we'll move to the second approach, that is fuzzy set approach. So what is happening in the case of fuzzy set approach? So in the case of fuzzy set approach, how the classification process is happening, we'll see. So fuzzy logic, actually here we are using fuzzy logic, uses the truth values between 0.0 and 1.0 to represent the degree of membership that a certain value has in a given category. So each category then represents a fuzzy set. So we are making use of the fuzzy logic here. So according to fuzzy logic, uses truth values between 0.0 and 1.0 to represent the degree of membership that a certain value has in a given category. Each category then represents a fuzzy set. Fuzzy logic systems typically provides graphical tools to assist users in converting attribute values to the fuzzy truth values. Fuzzy set theory is also known as possibility theory. It was actually proposed by Lord Fizeth in 1965 as an alternative to traditional two-value logic and probability theory. So we are using that fuzzy set theory and fuzzy logic in our classification process. It let us work at a high level of abstraction and offers means for dealing with imprecise of measurements of data. So most important, fuzzy set theory allows us to deal with vague or inexact facts. Unlike the notion of traditional crisp sets where an element either belongs to set S or to belonging to set S bar, etc. So in fuzzy set theory, elements can belong to more than one fuzzy set. Fuzzy set theory is useful for data mining systems performing rule-based classifications. So whenever we are using rule-based classification, this kind of fuzzy set theory will be helpful. It provides operations for combining fuzzy measurements. Several procedures exist for translating the resulting fuzzy output to a deficit or crisp values that is returned by the system. Fuzzy logic systems have been used in numerous areas for classification, including market research, finance, healthcare, and environmental engineering. So you can see in the diagram, there is one example. So how it is represented, like instead of representing a particular crisp value, like for example, income is equal to exactly what is it, 15k or 55k. Instead of that, we are taking a particular range. Income can become 10 to 30k. Next will be medium can be 20 to 50. High can be 40 above, etc. So in the case of a crisp values, if we are using exactly, if we are telling income 30k is income is equal to low, means it is 30k. So what about 25k or 20k? So that kind of questions will come if you are using the crisp exactly one set thing. That's why in the case of fuzzy set approach, we can have one particular data set belonging to multiple fuzzy sets, and it will help you to adjust that range of values. So in data mining, mainly we are using fuzzy set concept in rule-based classification methods. Now we will move to the third category, that is a rough set approach. So what about rough set approach? Again, rough set are used approximately or roughly define equivalence classes. So in rough set approach, we can use rough set approach to discover structural relationship within the imprecise and noisy data. So we can make use it in the case of noisy data. So the rough set theory is based on the establishment of equivalence classes within the given training data. The tuples that forms the equivalence classes are we can tell that the tuples that forms the equivalent classes are indiscernible. It means the samples are identical with respect to the attribute describing the data. So one particular class will have the similar kind of characteristics. There are some classes in the given real world data which cannot be distinguished in terms of available attributes. In such cases, we can say that rough set or to roughly define such classes. That means in all our examples, exactly it is like exactly we can divide like, okay, this particular X is belonging to this class or Y is belonging to the second class. If it is not possible, if it cannot be distinguished in terms of available attributes, then we can use the rough set to roughly define such classes. So for a given class C, you can see in the figure, for a given class C, the rough set definition is approximated by two sets as follows. Okay, lower approximation as well as upper approximation of C. So for a given class C, rough set definition is approximated by two sets of classes, lower approximation of C and upper approximation of C. The lower approximation of C consisting of all the data tuples that based on the knowledge of the attribute ascertained to belong to class C. Upper approximation of C, the upper approximation of C consisting of all the tuples that is based on the knowledge of attributes cannot be described as not belonging to C. So the diagram shows the upper approximation as well as the lower approximation of C. It is represented, right? So finding the minimal subset of attributes for feature reduction is NP-hard problem. But discernibility matrix, which stores the differences between the attribute values for each pair of data tuple, is used to reduce the computation intensity. So that's about the different methods. One is genetic algorithms method. In genetic algorithms method, it is like using the genetic algorithm concepts we are doing, and fuzzy set approach using fuzzy set theory and fuzzy logic we are making use. In the case of rough set approach, we are making roughly define the classes. We'll be using lower approximation and upper approximation concept. Thank you.